This is a TL494 IC based PWM control module for the inverter, which I have made on the PCB, and this is the feedback optocoupler PC817, and this is the 10 coulomb potentiometer for the voltage adjustment, and this is the current adjustment potentiometer. This is feedback wire, and these are the pins, including the current sensing pin and the VCC, PWM, and the ground pins. And this is the 10 nanofarad capacitor for the oscillator frequency adjustment. So the backside of this PCB I have made like this. So the PCB and circuit is also given in the description, you can check out. And also you can see the, I'm using the oscilloscope for the frequency and duty cycle adjustment. So I'm going connecting the 12 volt battery connector to this module, and on the screen we can see the frequency of 36 kilowatts, and duty cycle is clocked set as 45%. So the output waveform is a square wave, and this can be used for the high frequency inverter. So for the activation of the feedback, we have to connect 3.7 volt battery or any kind of voltage so that the feedback loop can be activated. And now I'm adjusting the potentiometer, and you can see on the screen the duty cycle is decreasing as the potentiometer is rotating in the clockwise. Duty cycle goes up to 0%, and now I'm increasing the duty cycle from 0%, and you can see the duty cycle almost 5 to 7%, and now I'm increasing more. So you can see the waveform is very sharpy, and you can also use for the 50 hertz low frequency inverters, because the this IC can be used for the low frequency and the high frequency inverters. And you can see the waveform, and also for the visual purpose I'm using this LED, and connecting at the output pins of this module. And in that case we can see the LED is glowing very bright as the 50% duty cycle at the output. So for now I'm decreasing the duty cycle from 50% to below as 0%. You can see the duty cycle decreasing little bit, and also brightness of the LED is also decreasing as the duty cycle decreases. Then and the LED is fully off as the duty cycle is 0%. So that's the way of this work of this module, and this is the first part of this video. And in the next video I'm gonna make a DC-DC buck converter, and also the buck and boost converter. And till then, and thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.